Before downloading, we first must connect the Wi-Fi to our BLK scanner. Select the scanner in the list, connect, and your computer will connect to the scanner. Now we can go ahead and launch Cyclone. Once Cyclone is open, there are a couple ways we can import. First, we can right-click on the server and then just say Import BLK, and the data will be stored in the default location. In this case, we will specify the location. Click on Databases, Add, then the three dots, which is Browse, and then we can browse to where we want to store it. We'll put it on the D drive, create a folder, and we'll call it Import BLK. Enter that folder, and now we can name our database. And we'll call it Import BLK to Cyclone. Hit Open, then OK, and the database has been created, and OK. Next, click on the plus to open up the tree, right-click on our new database, and say Import Manage BLK360. In the new window, we'll go ahead and click Find and Connect to Device. In the list of all the scans, these are all the scans that are stored on the scanner, and we'll go ahead and choose the ones that we want. In this case, it's the bottom two. We'll hit Import, and a new window will pop up. And all we need to do is choose Generate Thumbnails. This will help us during the registration process if we have more than one scan. Once we're done, hit OK. Scans and images will begin to be imported into Cyclone. Once finished importing, we can take a look at the scans. When the progress bar disappears, hit Close on the import box. We'll go up to our database, open it up by hitting the plus, hit the plus on the project, and we can see our two scans. Right-click on one, and then choose Open True Space. We'll first see intensity, colors. We can change to real colors by hitting the button that looks like a painter's palette. Change the size of the points, and we can also turn on the background image. We can pan around. We can also take measurements in here if we choose. Now this is importing into Cyclone. Once finished, you can close down the program.